osteoporosis. The name itself tells. Osteo is bone and porosis is porous. The bone is empty. Most common disease in humans, characterized by low bone mass, microarchitectural deterioration of bone, increase in bone fragility, and susceptibility to fracture. Medical impact. Osteoporosis generally does not become clinically apparent until a fracture occurs. Vertebra, proximal femur, and distal forearm, most common site of fractures in a person with osteoporosis. Patients suffer from pain, limited range of motion, disability, and deformity. It leads to psychological symptoms like depression and loss of self-esteem. Fractures associated with increased risk of mortality and future fractures. Most often it occurs in the elderly, so it becomes a big, tremendous hazard for the family. Osteoporosis financial impact. In India, approximately hospital cost per hip fracture. In the private setup, it is around 2 to 3 lakh rupees. In the government setup, it comes to around 25 to 30,000. The average hospital bed days, private 5 to 6 days, government setup 15 to 20 days. When I was in US around 5 years back, $300 million were spent for the treatment of low back ache and the spine fractures because of osteoporosis. So in one country, the sum is so huge. Imagine the number of patients and the amount of money spent in all the developed countries and the developing countries which are coming to their level. Osteoporosis, it's a serious public health problem worldwide. 1 in 3 women and 1 in 5 men over age 50 experience an osteoporotic fracture. A bone breaks due to osteoporosis every 3 seconds, second only to cardiovascular disease as a global healthcare problem. In India, 1 in 8 males and 1 in 3 females over age 50 suffer from osteoporosis. Lower age of peak incidence by at least 10 to 20 years compared to Western countries. Most common cause of this particular incidence lowering is the diet, malnutrition. Increase in population with osteoporosis increases with the life expectancy. More the age of the person, the osteoporosis increases. So what is the pathophysiology? Bone remodeling, necessary for bone strength. Bone resorption should be equal to bone formation. The input should be equal to the output. Aging, estrogen deficiency, or other metabolic derangements, etc. Osteoclast number, combination of two. Bone resorption is greater than bone formation, so the osteoporosis occurs. What are the main causes of osteoporosis? Lifestyle factors: alcohol abuse, smoking, active or passive, vitamin D insufficiency, inadequate physical activity, low calcium intake, high salt intake, excessive thinness, excess vitamin A, and immobilization. There are other causes of the osteoporosis also, like genetic diseases, hypogonadal states, endocrine disorders. Thyroid disorder is one of the most common causes of osteoporosis. When I have a patient in my OPD, I ask them only 3 questions. First of all, do you have diabetes mellitus? Second, do you have a thyroid insufficiency or a hypothyroidism? And third is, have you undergone hysterectomy? That is in females. GIT disorders, celiac disease, irritable bowel syndrome, gastric bypass, hematologic disorders, hemophilia, rheumatologic, all the rheumatoid arthritis and ankylosing spondylitis and all other types of inflammatory arthropathy, miscellaneous, stroke, Parkinson's disease, COPD. COPD is one of the most common causes of osteoporosis, not because of the disease itself, because of the treatment which the person is taking, that is steroids. CHF, ESRD, end-stage renal disease, the calcium formation becomes deranged. And one more common cause of osteoporosis is kidney stones or any type of stone in the body. The patient is given the instruction, don't take milk, don't take this, don't take any type of calcium nutrients. So the patient automatically goes into osteoporosis. Medications, anticoagulants, PPIs, methotrexate. So diagnosis, how the diagnosis of osteoporosis is made? History, clinical risk factors for osteoporosis related fractures. physical examination, bone mineral density assessment, vertebral imaging, and biochemical markers of bone turnover. Physical examination may reveal occult fractures. The most common, the easiest physical examination is just stand against the wall. If the occiput distance is more than 4 cm between the wall and your head, then your vertebral height has decreased. That is one of the most common signs of osteoporosis. What is bone mineral density? WHO defines osteoporosis in terms of bone mineral density. DEXA measurement of hip and spine used to establish diagnosis of osteoporosis. Normal bone mineral density, the T score is greater than or equal to 1, or sorry, minus 1. Low bone mass or osteopenia, the T score between minus 1 and minus 2.5. Osteoporosis, T score less than or equal to minus 2.5. It goes till minus 4. Indications for bone mineral density testing, regardless of clinical risk factors, women aged greater than or equal to 65, men aged greater than or equal to 70. In India, take it 25 years back. I think in my clinical practice, even people with 30 years of age or 28 years of age have shown the bone mineral density score of minus 4 and minus 3.5. With clinical risk factors for fracture, young postmenopausal women, women in menopausal transition, and men aged 50 to 69 with clinical risk for fracture. Adults who have fractured at or after age of 50. Adults with conditions like rheumatoid arthritis or taking medications like glucocorticoids associated with low bone mass or bone loss. Bone mineral density, what are the sites measure? How do we see what is the bone mineral density of one particular patient? DEXA of hip measured at femoral neck, quads, triangle, trochanter and intertrochanteric region. Basically the femur is taken. DEXA of lumbar spine measured over L1 through L4 vertebral bodies. DEXA scan is the bigger machine of the bone mineral density. We do often with the portable machine of the bone mineral density, which often takes phalanx or the calcaneum as the indicator of, as a measurement indicator of the bone mineral density. So BMD testing, importance of T score, Z score and caveats of diagnosis based on BMD. Difference between T score and Z score. T score, what is T score? Patient's T-score is BMD value compared with that of controlled subjects who are at the peak of their bone mineral density. Normally we do T-score, we don't do Z-score. Patient's Z-score is BMD value compared with that of persons matched for age and sex. In India, normally we don't get patients with 100% bone mineral density. Last September when we did a BMD camp for 3 days, 876 patients were tested, out of that only 11 came normal. That is the ratio in Sagar, Madhya Pradesh and the area surrounding Madhya Pradesh, because people came from all over these places. So out of 876, only 11 came normal. Vertebral imaging, vertebral fractures or vertebral imaging. Sign of impaired bone quality and strength, definitely you will see the trabecula. Trabecula means the bone is empty. Strong predictor of new vertebral and other fractures. Performed using lateral thoracic and lumbar spine x-ray, lateral vertebral fracture assessment using DEXA machine. Presence of a single vertebral fracture increases risk of subsequent fractures 5-fold, risk of hip and other fractures 2-3-fold. All these fractures, they increase the risk of subsequent fractures either because of the patient immobilization or inactivity or the debility caused because of the fractures. So what are the indications for vertebral imaging? Women aged greater than or equal to 70 and all men aged greater than or equal to 80 with T score at spine, total hip or femoral neck less than minus 1.0. All women aged 65 to 69 and all men aged 70 to 79 with T score at spine, total hip or femoral neck less than or equal to minus 1.5. Postmenopausal women and men aged 50 or older, mostly low trauma fracture during adulthood. The patient did not say that he has an accident or he has fallen down from the third floor. They say I was just walking and somebody pushed me and I fall down and I had a fracture. That is the meaning of low trauma fracture. Historical height loss of 1.5 inches or more. Vertical compression causes the height loss. prospective height loss of 0.8 inches or more, recent or ongoing long-term glucocorticoid treatment. So biochemical markers of bone turnover. Bone remodeling occurs throughout life. Biochemical markers of bone remodeling include resorption markers like serum C-telipeptide, CTX, and urinary N-telipeptide, NTX. Formation markers like serum bone-specific alkaline phosphatase and osteocalcin. Evaluating biochemical markers of bone turnover, risk of fracture, rapidity of bone loss, extent of fracture risk reduction after treatment, and magnitude of BMD increases with treatment. FRAX, WHO Fracture Risk Assessment Tool. FRAX tool developed by WHO to evaluate fracture risk of patients. FRAX algorithms gives 10-year probability of fracture. Risk factors included in WHO Fracture Risk Assessment Module. Current age, what is the age of the patient? Gender, prior osteoporotic fracture, femoral neck, bone mineral density, low BMI, oral glucocorticoids for greater than 3 months, rheumatoid arthritis, smoking, alcoholism, parental history of hip fracture, secondary causes of osteoporosis like type 1 diabetes mellitus, osteogenesis imperfecta in adults, untreated long-standing hypothyroidism, hypogonadism, premature menopause. There is a questionnaire calculation tool to assess the risk assessment with 10-year probability of fracture from a... Additional bone densitometry technologies, CT-based absorptiometry, trabecular bone scope, peripheral dual energy X-ray absorptiometry, and quantitative ultrasound densitometry. Management is dependent on two particular classes, general recommendations and pharmacological therapy. What can we advise patient? First of all, we will not give in initially the high dose of medicines to treat osteoporosis. First, you have to understand what does osteoporosis mean. Every patient must understand what is the meaning of osteoporosis. Just giving medicines, his BMD will increase, and subsequently after 3 months when you will check it again, again it will drop. So adequate daily intake of calcium and vitamin D. NOFA, National Osteoporosis Federation, and IOM recommend 1000 mg per day of calcium to men aged 50 to 70, 1200 mg per day of calcium to women aged greater than 51, and men aged greater than or equal to 71. Controlled clinical trials to reduce fracture risk with combination of supplemental calcium and vitamin D. NOF recommends 800 to 1000 international units of vitamin D per day for adults aged 50 and older. In vitamin D deficient individuals, high dose followed by maintenance therapy. You have to increase the vitamin D first. Vitamin D is a precursor of calcium, so then it will increase. General recommendations, regular weight bearing and muscle strengthening exercises, fall prevention, cessation of tobacco use, avoidance of excessive alcohol intake. Walk daily, that is the first thing which our orthopedic surgeon tells to his patient with low bone mineral density score. Exercise, calcium supplements, dietary calcium, smoking cessation, reduced alcohol consumption, and fall prevention programs. We cannot prevent the fall in India. That is our destiny. But at least we can make our bones strong to tolerate that fall. Pharmacological therapy, postmenopausal women and men aged 50 and older presenting with following to be considered. Vertebral fractures or hip fractures, hip decks or lumbar D, spine D score less than -2.5, low bone mass, 10-year probability of prior hip fracture greater than 3%, 10-year probability of major osteoporosis-related fracture greater than 20%. So what is the pharmacological therapy available for the treatment of bone mineral density? Anti-resorptive medications, bisphosphonates, alendronate, evandronate, risedronate, zoledronic acid, calcitonin, estrogens, estrogen or hormone therapy, estrogen agonist, antagonist, raloxifene, tissue selective estrogen complex, conjugated estrogen, bezetoxifene, anabolic medications, parathyroid hormone, teriparatide. Now it is very common in use, teriparatide. So, guidelines from American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists for choosing drugs to treat osteoporosis. First line agents, alendronate, risedronate, and zoledronic acid. Second line, evandronate. Third line, raloxifene. last line calcitonin. Patient with very high fracture risk or in whom bisphosphonate therapy has failed, teriparatide. Newer agents, denosumab, fully human monoclonal antibody against rankle, inhibits osteoclast-mediated bone resorption, reduced incidence of fractures after 3 years of use, vertebral by 68%, hip fractures by 40%, and non-vertebral fractures by about 20%. Gain in BMD after 10 years of therapy, lumbar spine 21.7%, total hip 9.2%. All these therapies which we are talking about are extremely expensive. They are not very low-cost drugs. Evidence-based clinical efficacy of medicines, all these things, how to be taken and how, what are their complications and how to, what else to be done. Other newer agents like strontium renalate promotes bone formation as well as inhibits bone resorption. Evidence shows after 3 years of use, 37% reduction in vertebral fractures. 5 years, 43% reduction. 3 years of use, 14% reduction in non-vertebral fractures. 5 years of use, 24% reduction in vertebral fractures. Long-term registrative trials after 5 years demonstrate gain in BMD, bone quality improvement, and reduction in risk of vertebral and non-vertebral fractures. Clinical pulse, tips, indication, insights for pharmacological agents, combination sequential therapy, precautions, appropriate patient profile. It is actually not in very common use, all these drugs. Teriparatide is little in use, alendronate, zoledronic acid. As I have already told you, all these drugs are extremely expensive to the normal patient. The best thing to be told him, please take this coconut, banana, milk, whenever it is possible, curd, and groundnut, jaggery, all these low-cost, day-to-day life things, I think they have the same results as those long, expensive therapies, which I think a normal Indian patient cannot sustain for a very long time or till the end of the treatment. Now, these drugs are on the horizon. Anti-sclerostin antibodies, sclerostin, osteocyte-derived inhibitors of osteoclast action. Inhibition of sclerostin, bone formation is promoted. Bromosomab, humanized monoclonal antibody inhibits sclerostin and has dual effect of promoting bone formation in Indian resorption. Some of them are injected subcutaneously, some of them are to be taken as oral, some of them are to be taken as nasal. Patient compliance is to be taken into account. Educated patient will do whatever you will say. Uneducated patient will never do what you will say. Parathyroid hormone related protein, abaloparatide, novel synthetic peptide analog of parathyroid hormone, anabolic agent for postmenopausal osteoporosis, self-administered daily subcutaneous injection, NDA submitted to food development authority. Abaloparatide, active phase 3 studies. These are all the details of the studies which have been done for the drugs, cathepsin, K inhibitors, major osteoclast, proteolytic enzyme in bone, increases the bone mass, improves bone architecture and strength. Cathepsin K inhibitors, odanacatib, cathepsin K inhibitor, it was stopped because of the risk of stroke. So basically, what is the conclusion, what we have derived from this lecture on osteoporosis? It's a condition associated with significant morbidity and mortality. Last decade has witnessed veritable revolution in osteoporosis diagnosis and therapeutics. The diagnosis has increased, but the patients have remained the same. Much success achieved has been due to enhanced understanding of basic bone biology. Bone density remains most valid and reliable measure of fracture risk. FRAX, other new imaging approaches help bone health evaluation and identify fractures earlier. Number of medications available for management of osteoporosis. All drug possesses specific advantages, specific side effects. They all have very long-term therapies. Some of them to be taken empty stomach. Some of them to be taken as subcutaneous injections. Some of them have other complications like hot flushes, deep vein thrombosis, embolism. So basically, there is need for drugs that could, with high safety, increase the bone mass. improve biomechanics and reduce fracture risk more than they do existing products, while giving long-lasting benefits even if treatment is stopped, which will happen eventually if the patient will not understand how serious the problem is osteoporosis. They will just say, "Hame thoda sa dard ho raha tha, humne dawai di, hame aaram lag gaya." Next time when they will come, they will have pain again. Then they will try to find out the doctor. They will never do the completion of the treatment, which is very important in the treatment of osteoporosis. New and potentially highly effective agents may offer novel therapeutic tools to contract osteoporosis epidemic. Thank you so much.